So by the end of this video, you're going to be a pro at using the ideal gas law, PV equals NRT. So how do you even know when to use the ideal gas law? One key, this N, stands for moles. So if you have moles, it's probably going to be the ideal gas law, like this. Right here in this problem, we have moles. But if you have an initial and a final condition, like you have a temperature or a pressure that changes, like this problem, where the volume, the liters, changes, and then we have the pressure here changing, that's going to be the combined gas law. So if you see moles, you're thinking PV equals NRT, and if things change, you're thinking combined gas law. That's how you know. Let's talk about R, because that can be a source of confusion. So here I've set a problem up. And right here is the value for R. And the reason I use this value for R is because my pressure is ATM. So I have to have ATM in R. And R cancels everything out except what we're looking for. So R kind of fixes the units for us. That's why we need it. If instead of atmospheres here, you had millimeters of mercury, you'd need to use a value for R that has millimeters of mercury. If you have kPa, you just need to remember this value of R. And usually you're given a table with all these for tests. So in short, look at the pressure in the problem here, the units, choose the right value for R, everything should cancel out, and it should fix your units. All right, let's do some problems. So here's a typical PV equals NRT, ideal gas law problem. Pause and see if you can set it up. We have our atmospheres here, that's pressure, volume in liters. We have our moles here, R, we're gonna look up. And we're looking for temperature. What is the temperature? So here's how I set it up. And I chose this value for R because pressure's in atmospheres, so I needed one that had atmospheres. So now all I need to do is get T by itself. I could divide both sides by this here. That way all of this is the same on the top and the bottom. That cancels out, and I'll have T over here. Let's get rid of this. And now, because we chose the correct R, we have atmospheres here and here, they cancel out, liters cancel out, moles, moles, we're going to be left with Kelvin. Multiply the top, multiply the bottom, and divide the numerator by the denominator, and we get 146.2 Kelvin. Our significant figures aren't exactly right, but let's not worry about that right now. Let's try another one. Let's go back and look at R again. So one thing you'll notice for R here, we have liters. So if you're given milliliters in a problem, you've got to change it to liters. Divide your milliliters by 1,000, that gives you liters. And temperature, that's in Kelvin. If you're given Celsius, you've got to change it to Kelvin. Add Celsius plus 273.15, you have Kelvin. And finally, moles. If you're given grams, you need to change that to moles. Divide by the molar mass. If you need help with any of these, there are links in the descriptions. Make sure your units are correct. So pause, give this problem a try. I've changed my milliliters here to liters. I'm looking for moles, so I don't need to do anything there. And I was given Celsius. I changed that to Kelvin over here. So my units all match R. So now to get moles by itself, N, I divide both sides by this here. All of this is gone. Let's get rid of it. All of the units cancel out, except for moles. That's what we're looking for. Multiply the top and the bottom, divide the numerator by the denominator. We end up with 0.027 moles. So pause and give this one a try. And there's lots going on. You've got milliliters and temperature in Celsius. You've got to change that. And then you've got a pressure, mmHg. So make sure you choose the right value of R. I gave you two of them. Give it a try. So since our pressure is in millimeters of mercury, we'll use this value for R, although you could convert to atmospheres and use this value if you wanted. Here's how I set this up. Since I have millimeters of mercury here, I chose the R that had that value in its units here. I changed my milliliters to liters, and then my degrees Celsius to Kelvin, divide both sides by this here. So all of that cancels out. the units, they cancel out. I'm left with moles, and when I do the math, I end up with 0.129 moles. So those are the big ideas for the ideal gas law here. Remember, make sure you choose the right value for R, and then make sure all your units that you're using in this ideal gas law match up as well. Everything should cancel out. This is Dr. B with the Ideal Gas Law. Thanks for watching.